Hello, welcome to this video. In a short time, you will have all you need to start using Corel PaintShop Pro 2018. Leave us suggestions in the video description to improve our next video guides for this software. PaintShop Pro is a great photo editing software used to edit and retouch your favorite photos and pictures by applying amazing effects and corrections. When opening it, a welcome page is shown. In order to quickly start with a new or saved project, choose your favorite template or check out the latest updates from Corel World. At the very top, you have several buttons representing the several workspaces available inside PaintShop. The Home button opens the Welcome page. Manage is used to create and browse your collections of photos. Edit is used to apply corrections, adjustments, and effects on your selected photos. Besides these, there is also the Adjust workspace, which is hidden by default. If you go to File, Preferences, General Program Preferences, and then choose the Tabs section, you can show the Adjust workspace by checking it and accepting it with OK below. This is used to apply effects and adjustments in a more easier way in respect to the Edit 1. Let's start with the Manage workspace. This is divided in several palettes, such as the Preview on the center, the Navigation palette on the left, and the Organizer at the bottom, and the Info palette on the right. You can use their cross button to close and hide them from the interface. To reopen them, just go to the View and then to Palettes. You can use the Navigation palette to browse for your own pictures by using the Computer or the Collections tab. When you select Computer, you can browse for your media directly from your computer folders, any hard drive, or disk. When you select a folder, all its media will show up on the Organizer palette. With the Collections tab, you browse for your media grouped and listed inside Collections, according to your own ratings, place, people, or tags. Besides the Organizer palette, you can use the Preview to check your media. This works in three modes, all listed in the top right corner. When in map mode, the preview shows the world map to check or edit the places where your photos were taken. If you use the preview mode, the preview shows the picture selected from the organizer palette below. When in thumbnail mode, the preview becomes your organizer, showing all media depending on the folder or collection selected. Use the zoom bar at the bottom to regulate the zoom. You have several useful buttons at the bottom of the preview, such as the Share button and the Rotate buttons, to rotate by 90 degrees. When you double-click on a picture, you will check it in full-screen mode. This shows a small interface with the Rotate buttons. Use the arrow buttons to change picture, the star rating, and the Bin button to delete the current image. You can also use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out, and click and drag to pan. Use the Escape key to exit. Take a look at the Info palette on the right. This shows all metadata information on the selected picture, including ratings, people, and places. Once you have a picture selected, you can switch either to the Adjust or the Edit workspace to adjust it. Let's start with Adjust. This workspace shows different palettes. On the center, you have the preview to check your image carefully. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out, and click and drag while holding the space bar to pan. At the bottom, you have the Organizer palette to choose the image to edit. On the left, the Adjust palette with everything regarding corrections. And on the right, the Instant Effects palette used to apply outstanding effects. In the top left corner of the preview, you find again the Share button, the Rotate buttons, and the Bin button. The Adjust palette is divided into three parts: a color histogram on top, several useful tools on the center, and the adjustment options at the bottom. The color histogram describes the amount of red, green, and blue colors on the picture, including the brightness level, darker on the left and lighter on the right. Check out the video description if you want to know more about the color histogram. In the center, you can enable several tools to apply on the picture directly on its preview. Use the crop tool to cut out parts of the photo you don't like. When enabled, the preview shows a grid representing the part of the picture to save. You can click and drag it to move, or use several nodes to scale it. Click and drag outside the node to rotate. You can also create the grid area directly by clicking and dragging from outside. You can also set the tool options on the Adjust palette, for example, to keep the aspect ratio, or to size the grid area precisely. To crop, just click on Apply. Use the Straighten tool to align pictures horizontally by moving the verticals of the segment shown and clicking on Apply on the Adjust palette. Use the Red Eye tool to remove red eyes. Regulate the diameter size first, and then click on the red eyes. The Makeover tool collects several tools to improve people's faces. Blemish Fixer corrects skin imperfections. Toothbrush whitens teeth. Eye Drop brightens up eyes. Suntan colors skin by brushing on the picture. And Thinify makes bodies thinner. Make sure not to apply this tool too many times in order to not cause distortion. Use the Clone Brush tool to apply very precise corrections by providing a reference point on the picture, shown as a cross. This tool corrects the brushed parts by following such reference according to the blend mode chosen on the Adjust palette. This allows you to apply corrections that fit the shapes and colors of the image itself. All you have to do is set the tool options on the left, such as blend mode, brush size, and hardness. Right-click on the picture to fix a reference, and then click and drag to brush. Remember to use Ctrl and Z to undo your last actions in case you make a mistake. You can also use the Undo and Redo buttons at the top of the Preview to undo and redo your actions. Below these tools, you'll have several selections used to apply corrections on the whole picture. Depth selection is used to set the depth level of the photo. Smart Photo Fix is used to adjust all the main properties of the image, such as the overall brightness level, the brightness of the darker sides with shadows, the lighter side with highlights, and the color intensity with saturation. In particular, you can turn an image into black and white by applying a negative 100 saturation level. To change any of these properties, you can click and drag the marker, use your mouse wheel, type the value directly, or use the up and down arrows. You can also use Suggest Settings to apply automated settings. At the very bottom of each section, you have two buttons. Use Revert to reset all changes made from the current selection. And hold your pointer on Show Original to check your original picture in respect to the current one modified. Below, use Brightness Contrast to adjust the brightness and contrast levels. Use White Balance to set the general color on the picture with temperature and tint, and Vibrancy to fix its intensity. If the photo looks blurry or shows noise, you can correct with Fill Light Clarity, High Pass Sharpen, and also Digital Noise Removal. Use Local Tone Mapping to adjust the photo appearance by acting locally. On the right, you can apply several effects on your photos with Instant Effects. Select the collection from the list above and click on the effect to check what your picture looks like with it through the smaller preview on top. To apply it definitely, just double-click on it. Use Ctrl and Z to undo the effect. Let's see the Edit Workspace. In respect to the Adjust Workspace, this collects several tools which can be applied on limited portions of the photo and not anywhere. On the center, you have the Preview, where you can zoom and pan on the selected photo. And at the bottom, you have the Organizer palette to select the photo by double-clicking. All the tools to correct and edit your photos are collected inside the Tools toolbar on the left. Here you find the Crop tool, the Straighten tool, the Red Eye tool, and the Clone Brush tool, seen already. You also have other buttons below, some grouped together within the down arrow you see. You can use the Paintbrush tool to brush your favorite colors by clicking and dragging. From the Materials palette, choose two colors, such as the Foreground, applied when you use your left click, and the Background button, applied when you right click. Below the Paintbrush tool, you have several adjustment tools in order to correct brightness, contrast, and hue by brushing on the sides of the picture you need to fix. The Tools option above is very useful. For each tool enabled, this bar shows all its options, such as the brush size, shape, and hardness. You have the Selection tools. These are used to select a part of the picture so that when you apply the correction or adjustment on the picture, you will affect the selected part only. Another great tool is the Text tool. When enabled, double-click on the picture to start typing. Then adjust the font style, size, font and stroke colors by using the Tool options on top. If you need any help with the Edit Workspace tool, remember to read on the Learning Center palette for some more useful information on how to use them. Once you finish editing your picture, you can save it by going to File and then to Save As. Decide file name, format, and also the compression level. The higher the compression level, the lower the quality and the smaller the file size. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides.